Welcome to a new edition of our show titled Speak of Africa. For the show of today, I have a very important guest I want to introduce to you. His name is Pastor Timothy Alabi. Welcome, Pastor Timothy Alabi, to our show.
Thank you.
Pastor Timothy Alabi is a pastor of Evidence of Christ Fellowship International Church, located in Maryland, USA. As a serious believer in Christ, I wanted him to say something to our viewers because we all believe in Christ. So I just want to start by asking him, the name of your church, Evidence, when you talk about evidence, what does that strike you?
Thank you, Mr. Prince Ojong, for having me. In the first place, I want to appreciate your effort to bring me into this forum. So going back to your question, when you talk of evidence, what does that mean? That is a very serious word that needs to be taken seriously by everyone. Evidence means to be able to see a picture of whatever you say in your life. For example, we say evidence of Christ. Everybody know what Christ is the Messiah. Everybody knows what Jesus Christ stands for. They know, they've heard him, they know his character, they know everything about him. So when we say evidence, we are being challenged that whenever you see us, you hear us, you must see the same evidence that was in Jesus Christ, based both in the word spoken, written, and in the living. And that is what the word evidence portrays. And that's why we choose that word evidence.
Thank you very much, Pastor Alabi. We're going to follow up. We've spent so much time watching a lot of your videos on YouTube.
Thank you.
We've watched so many videos on YouTube. When we watch most of these videos on YouTube, they give us the impression that most of your friends who are pastors are not really men of God. We get the impression that they are merchants of Venice. Do you agree or you disagree?
Thank you very much. Most of the pastors in the world should have gotten to a different profession. Because there are different kind of business in the world. We have over hundreds of businesses. So as for those pastors, they are in the wrong profession because the word pastor is not meant for business. It's meant to be crucified. It's meant to suffer with Jesus Christ. It's meant to be able to experience everything Jesus Christ experienced, his chastisement, his rebuke, his neglect, his ignoring. So at the end of the day, you are doing a wrong business because we have no money. So I will rather want them to go back to a business, that a money-making business, like franchising to McDonald's, or maybe like real estate, or maybe insurance. Those are where money is. So they are in the wrong profession. That's why I keep mentioning their name, so that one day they will sit with their wife and they will think that this is not a place for money making. It's not a business venture. Let's go back into farming or into real estate or into insurance. And that's why we keep mentioning their name.
The first name I see in your videos a whole lot is Enoch Adeboye. Who is this person? Is he a messenger of God?
$250 to $6,000. Quick tax refund advance made easy. It's tax season 2019. The Christmas and New Year holidays are over. Everybody's talking about the PJ Tax Service, the new kid in town on H&R Block's block. Why? Money, money, money. Spread the good news. Quick tax refund advance is here. It's big, bigger than ever. Put big money in your pocket fast. PJ Tax Service. Nobody gets your tax money back faster, instantly, quickly, and immediately. Three tax refund disbursement choices for you in less than 24 hours. Visa e-card, paper check, and direct deposit. Get your money back without delays. PJ Tax Service has your back. It is your money, so get it now. PJ Tax Service. You like the way we do your taxes. PJ Tax Service. You feel like a lottery or a sweepstake winner. Act now. Call 301-593-4879 or 301-593-4897. Or come to our office, 11207A, Lockwood Drive, Silver Spring, Maryland, 20901. Or you can visit us online, www.pjtaxservice.com.
If you look at the history of Enoch Adeboye, Pastor Enoch Adeboye, his mother told him, based on maybe going to Ifa or whatever, that he will be a popular person. Now is that influence of popularity has overtaken him to think that he's now living what his mother told him. But that is not Jesus Christ. You cannot be popular if you are really speaking Jesus Christ. It's not possible. You cannot be well known. They will know you in rebuking you, in chastising you, in ignoring you, in beating you. In fact, if to say you are representing, so Enoch Adeboye is not really representing Jesus Christ at all. Far from it. He's a complete businessman. He's only venture into a wrong business. That's all. So Pastor Adeboye, I will say, a very serious businessman in the wrong business. Maybe tomorrow I will advise him to go to insurance business or to mortgages business, but not into we're calling Jesus alone, making to be fraud. Making Jesus Christ and adding it to business, as Pastor Adeboye is rightly doing now, is a fraud person. He's supposed to be prosecuted and end up in jail. Pastor Enoch Adeboye is supposed to be in jail today, right now. And I will keep calling his name until he's prosecuted and go to jail. Or until he changes his business to real estate or to insurance. But as long as he chooses to be doing the business in the name of my Lord and my Savior, Jesus Christ, we are in a warfare and have won. I'm victorious because Jesus Christ is completely on my side. Jesus Christ is not on his side. That's why he's having problem upon problem. Don't you know to maintain a jet is a problem? To maintain limousine is a problem? To maintain crowd is a problem? That's why Adeboye need help. He has problems upon problems. And we continue to have that problem until he gets out of that name Jesus and go and establish a real estate or ask them to franchise McDonald's for him. That is what I know about. So Pastor Adeboye is in the wrong business. It's fraud.
Okay.
And he's supposed to be prosecuted and go to jail.
Yeah, it seems Mr. Femi Falana really supports much of what you're saying. But what about William Kumuyi? That's another pastor we see in a lot of your videos. What is wrong with him?
Pastor William Kumuyi is also in the fraud. Why? Is because whenever someone is discussing about Jesus Christ, that person must be willing to be questions. That person must be willing to explain to others. You must not be above anyone when they ask you questions. That is not the case of Pastor Kumuyi. No one in his audience can ask him questions. He will ask the person to shut up. So if you go back to my YouTube, you see that Pastor Kumuyi is also doing business, just like every other one of them. And brother, anyone that do business call in the name of Jesus is fraud and need to be persecuted and go to jail. So just as Pastor Enoch Adeboye supposed to be in jail, Pastor William Kumuyi is supposed to be in jail. They both of them doing business. The same advice I give to Pastor Adeboye is what I give to Pastor Kumuyi. Go and franchise McDonald's. Go to real estate, go to insurance, go to agric. But as long as you are doing business with Jesus, you will go to jail.
Okay. What about Chris Okoti? I used to know Chris Okoti the days when he used to be a singer. He came up with songs like Carolina, It's Wrong, on most college campuses, I think Unilag. That's where he got his fame. Then suddenly, we heard that now he has become a pastor. But it looks like you have so many things also to say about Chris Okoti.
Thank you for question on Chris Okoti. First of all, Chris Okoti only changed business. He is looking for a very good business. He's a business person. He started knowing that singing is a good business, making money. And he was making money. But it's not enough for him. Still looking for a way of business. So he found out that when he look at someone like Pastor Adeboye, someone like Pastor Kumuyi, making a lot of millions. And his own music is not making that much. So overnight, he turned to become a pastor. And you can see the difference now when he's a pastor versus when he was a musician, he's making more money. So not only Okoti, there are millions of pastors that found out that the same way Pastor Kumuyi is making money, the same way Pastor Kumuyi is making money, they can make money. So everybody now is a pastor. Because the best business right now in the world is to be a pastor. First of all, you'll be answering, they will be answering yes sir to you. That's famous. You'll be famous, and also you will still have money, and you wake up by 11 o'clock a.m. and you do whatever you want to do. Nobody query you, don't pay tax. I mean, what business can beat that in the world? Okay. If I do not really know Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior, that would be the kind of business I have chosen myself. And I'm admonishing those who really want to do business to go to pastor school.
Okay.
Because that's the quickest way of making money. And if you want an idea, talk to Pastor Enoch Adeboye and Okoti. They will teach you how they become millionaires overnight. Because the best business now in the world is church.
Okay.
And it's pastor. So don't just go to church. Be a pastor. And then you become millionaires overnight. It's a complete business venture.
So is it that maybe they are learning from people like Kenneth Copeland, Jim Baker, and Joel Austin, some of these American preachers? Are the African pastors learning from these televangelists?
I'm glad that you make mention of those American pastors. Don't forget that we are colonized. So the same colon, we are colonized economically, politically, psychologically, and religiously. So the aspect of colonization of religion is what is just coming out.
Okay.
So actually, they are promoting what is from the Western Union as a business back to Africa. So it's the same thing.
Okay.
It's just like how we look at our containers. Everything that is in Africa is contained from here,
mm-hmm.
including religion.
Yes.
So there's nothing big deal.
Okay.
So American pastors, they are the one who started the business with Jesus. They know how to do it very well. There's no American pastor that you know, as you mentioned them, there are thousands and one of them more who knows that the best business is pastoring. So it's a business, and that business arises from Western world, and now it's in Africa. Africa is only trying to make sure they do it more than them.
Okay.
But they are leaders, they are teachers, they are moderators. Americans and Britons and France, pastors.
Okay.
So it's the same business.
Life insurance money secrets of millionaires and billionaires exposed. Discover how America's rich and famous exploit these arcane tools to build fabulous wealth. Why should these big white guys have all the fun? Let Prince Ojong, the celebrity author of The Miraculous Millionaire, show you the little understood life insurance way to riches. Are you still doubting the good things that life insurance can do for you? Trust strategies, estate planning, 401k rollover, annuity contract, cash value, education funding, executive benefits, income protection, life protection, living benefits, mortgage protection, tax-free retirement? Think and grow rich with life insurance. Your amazing journey to wealth begins by calling Prince Ojong at 240-350-1131.
Now, what about Billy Graham? I know the son, Franklin, has taken over now. I noticed you were criticizing Billy Graham, saying he's more of an entertainer.
Billy Graham is also among the business people. He's a business person. Don't forget, when you are doing business, you have different way of accomplishing your objective and goal. Mm-hmm. Billy Graham chose to a nation acknowledgement for his own business. Billy Graham is very popular in his business. Everybody knows him. That's a good business person. But the only problem he has is he's using Jesus, and he was successful. In fact, Billy Graham shows that he's a very good business person by making sure before he died, his own son take over, because it's a property. You know, it's an asset. So how can you expect me, having worked for many years, that stranger will now take up my asset and my wealth? So Billy Graham is a good example that shows clearly that Christianity is business. Pastoring is business. And if you want to go to the history of Billy Graham, you will find out that in all that he has done so far, is complete business nature. It has nothing to do with Jesus. So don't be fooled, because they express Jesus is the Savior, is coming back. Devil can do that. There's nothing new in that. In fact, it was said that devil believed God and he trembled. These people do not fear God, they do not even tremble. Because once you can take a 1 cent from, because you are naming the name of Jesus, you are a fraud. You are a business person in the wrong business. Anyone who can be capitalizing on taking $1, $2 in the name of Jesus as a pastor, because he has congregation, he's supposed to be prosecuted and go to jail. So Billy Graham supposed to go to jail himself, just like Pastor Enoch Adekoya Adeboye, just like Kumuyi, because they depend on this Jesus to eat.
Okay.
So it's fraud. Okay. They're supposed to go to jail.
So what are you doing to make sure that Evidence of Christ Fellowship International should not be like these televangelist organizations?
I'm very happy with that question. Evidence of Christ Fellowship International has been operating for the past 38 years. You can check our record. You can never see where one is taking $1 from another life. Because the principle is religion or Christianity should not be a business. No pastor must take $1. Once you are taking $1 in the name of Jesus, you are in business. So as far as Evidence of Christ Fellowship is concerned, go to our record. No one can you say has taken $1 in the name of Jesus in the midst. In fact, we give out from our own business. For example, as I'm here with you, I'm a complete engineer. And I make money being an engineer. And I pour it into Evidence of Christ Fellowship Ministry, so that others can go to school, others can live, so that they can also be educated and become engineers like me, so that they too be pouring money into the same pocket.
So, Pastor Alobi, do your members pay tithes?
First of all, the tithe that they pay is to be able to boost out their business. You do not ask someone who have not eaten and drank, who has not been able to successfully eat, or his children are not able to go to school to be paying tithe, called tithe. That is because we want you to boost your own business. If you are truthful and you are sincere, the what pays me is that they use the name of Jesus. How many times do Jesus ask for tithe? How many times did Paul ask for tithe? How many times did Peter ask for tithe? These are the names they are calling when they are trying to brainwash their so-called members so that their business can boom. But none of them, their members have asked them, did Peter ever ask for tithe? Did Paul ever ask for tithe? Did Jesus actually have asked for tithe? Well, so that means they are tithe, getting tithe is a kind of how are we going to boost this business so it can continue to grow. This is how you know. Everyone we have mentioned today, they try to make sure that if their son is not next to them, their relative is. Mm-hmm. Because they want their assets to be, they want to grow. Mm-hmm. You grow, they are growing their business. It's only in evidence of Christ that I know that you come into that you will not see relative relationship kind of thing. You will not see sonship kind of thing. Because it's not business at all. It's not family thing at all. It's not relative things at all. It's not family thing at all. This is Jesus. In fact, many will not be able to come to evidence of Christ because if you come, you will experience suffering for the sake of Jesus Christ. You will experience beating. You will experience flogging instead of giving event. So when we mention tithe, our tithe is how you'll be flogged because of Jesus Christ. How you'll be beaten because of Jesus Christ. That's tithe. Okay. How you will suffer because of Jesus. That is really tithe. Okay. Because our goal is what is acceptable before God. What is acceptable before Jesus Christ.
Okay.
And that's our goal. And if you want to reference this, you can talk to anyone in the name of Christ. They will tell you that if you come, you will pay tithe of suffering, of being beaten, of reproach. This everything they do to Jesus Christ, they will do it to you. Because of the fact that that is what tithe is. Yes. And this is mentioned in the book of Luke chapter 14, verse 26 to 33.
In the Bible, Jesus went to the church and found people selling stuff. From this, I would assume that Jesus would not like most of these your friends who are pastors.
Thank you very much.
You remember the incident when Jesus went to the church and sent them all away?
Yes. In fact, the only way people be joining those ones is because they just like in the world of business, when you have sweet mouth, your business will sell. When you know how to love people, your business, that's the same thing. Jesus Christ, from what you have just quoted, shows that his name can never be used for business. Because when he saw them buying and selling, like you said, that's business, right?
Mm-hmm.
He saw that they are doing the right thing in the wrong place.
Thank you.
They would have gone to outside
mm-hmm.
and be doing those things. But when they come inside to come and buy and sell, Jesus Christ proved that this is not a business place. Unlike what Pastor Kumuyi, Pastor Adeboye, Okotie, Billy Graham are doing today. They are not only selling, they are selling the souls of men in addition.
Mm-hmm.
So to me, it's just too much.
Okay.
But again, you have to understand this. Our Lord and our Jesus, the question you will have asked me is, how will Jesus Christ will have failed now? Jesus Christ is crying and weeping because a like Kumuyi, Adeboye, Okotie, Billy Graham, that are doing business because of his name. Imagine me now.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody come and use my name for things that I will not be happy with. And you want me to be happy? No. In fact, Jesus Christ proved that he will not be happy for you using his name for business by selling those ones who are buying and selling out of the synagogue.
And it looks like most of them are even selling products in these churches, like books. You get like Jim Baker, he went to jail, he came back. I realized that the guy is doing the same thing he did before he went to jail.
Business that is making money for you, you cannot let go. Go to jail and come back, you can't let go of a business that has no sovereign in it. You don't pay tax. I mean, what other business can beat the business of church, the business of religion? So, in essence, this business is flourishing, and it will continue like that.
Mm-hmm.
So, actually, there's no second business that can beat the business of church, of religion, church of Christianity today.
Mm-hmm.
So, we expect them to continue this business because that is the only business, a very simple business, business that you don't have, you don't even need a collateral. You don't need, in fact, you don't need nothing. In fact, you don't have to be there.
Mm-hmm.
Like Riley said, they're selling books. They have to sell books. In fact, they'll be selling food
mm-hmm.
very soon.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, they'll be selling
prayers.
I mean, they'll be selling. I mean, they have been not me. This is a good business. Let me encourage you again. Those of you that are ordinary bench worker, warmers in the church, I will advise you, go and do a business, a good business. Go to pastor school and come back to church and be selling books and be selling food. You will make money. These are your people. They are your mentor. They make millions. You can make millions too.
But you make millions and go to hell. Is that not the truth?
Those life, Pastor Kumuyi, Pastor Adeboye,
will they go to
Pastor
heaven?
Billy Graham, Pastor Okoti, and many millions of pastors, none of them is thinking of where they go.
Really?
They're only telling you in the mouth because it's part of their business. None of them is ever thinking of that when they get home.
Uh-oh.
But they have to tell you because if you discover it in the Bible, you will challenge them.
Okay.
So that you not challenge them and say, okay, you will not, so that you not go to hell. But in actual fact, they don't care where they go.
Really?
No.
Where?
They don't care. Where. It is you that really care where you go that's supposed to think and see them.
So they don't believe in heaven or hell?
None of these people in practice believe in heaven or hell. They believe in how much money they can make. They believe in how much they can use your life and my life to make money. They know that they will quickly go to jail if they kill you and make money. But they are killing you, your souls, mm-hmm. to make the same money.
Yes.
So they don't believe in hell or heaven. No. They can tell you a mouth. In fact, they can quote all Bible to support that they believe. But the lifestyle
mm-hmm.
shows that they don't believe. So that is why this fraud.
Okay.
And you know that once, well, no matter any kind of fraud you commit in church, you will go free.
Mm-hmm.
Because they call it a sanctified place.
Okay.
That is why it's a good business.
Okay.
So even armed robbers are now pastors, drug addicts are now pastors, prostitutes are now pastors, everyone in the world, voodoo makers are now pastors, magicians are pastors, because that is the best business.
Okay.
It's tax-free.
I know that. I do taxes, so I know how tax-free it is. And I know that most of them, they create a 501c3 organization. And with that, you don't pay any taxes. So if somebody wants to create a church, I can help you create a 501c3. But when you look at that, your soul probably is what I feel bad about. But I realize that when I watch your videos, you talk a lot about salvation. What can you share on this show about salvation?
Thank you very much. If you truly know Jesus Christ, every one of your, if you truly know Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, every word you mention must be about the coming back of Jesus, about salvation, about a sinless life, about holy life, righteous and perfect life, about every one of your sins will be exactly the characteristic of Jesus Christ as he has given to us in the book of John chapter 14 verse 26, in the book of John 15 verse 8 to 11, no, 13 to 11, in the book of Luke chapter 14. In all the scripture given by Jesus Christ, he emphasized Me, my will, my in kingdom, my kingdom. If you are serious and you don't want to go to a business church, you go to a place where it's all about the kingdom of God, not about tithe, not about money. No, not about building, but Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is coming back. Is the way, the truth is the life. And then live the life. And you will mix with others that are in the same thing with you and living the life that Peter lived, Paul lived, and every of the disciples indeed lived. That is how you will know that this is not a business place. That's how to identify a business place versus non-business place. And your life will be saved.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. Do you think there's something we've not asked you which you may want to tell our audience?
What you have not asked me that I would like to tell the audience has to do with many of the comments they made concerning my messages on the YouTube. And I say they make mention of this comment in their way because they have no Holy Spirit. When Jesus Christ was living, the only thing he left behind on how you will know him is Holy Spirit. There's no how you will know whom Jesus Christ is without crying and weeping for Holy Spirit. In fact, in the book of Acts of Apostles, he told his disciples precisely, tarry, if this Holy Spirit do not come unto you, do not do anything. And you can see the difference when that Holy Spirit came. You can see what Peter was and what Peter became after the Holy Spirit. Everyone we are talking about today, they are not coming close to with Holy Spirit. Because the first thing you will do when you come in contact with Holy Spirit is you will not want to do business with the name of Jesus. You will not emphasize on tithe. You will not emphasize on crowd. You will not emphasize on things that are carnal. But Holy Spirit of God alone can do this. And let me tell you, God will never visit you with his power, because that is his power, that is his hope. Himself is Holy Spirit. And he will never visit you until he know that truly you are not going to make merchandise of the souls of his people, until he know that you are not going to make business of himself. So yes, they can be calling Holy Spirit the Holy Spirit fire. Holy Spirit is a lie. These are the ones that are calling Holy Spirit and still making business right in the church. The same thing Jesus Christ did to those who are selling and buying and throw them out. Today, he will do more than that. He will beat them. He will beat like Adeboye, beat like Kumuyi, beat like Christo Kotie, beat like Billy Graham. Because they are all business people. They only in the wrong business. They're supposed to go to 7-Eleven or franchise with McDonald's or maybe cleaning. Those are the good business for them. But that will not make as much money as being their so-called pastor.
Exactly. Okay, thank you very much for coming, and we're very, very happy with your message. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Selling a service or a product? Need buyers? Use the African Nation TV as a channel to reach many viewers. Act now and call Prince Ojong at 240-350-1131. That's 240-350-1131. Act today.